Attorney Cayosa, si Amy Pamintuan from the Philippine Star. The Defense Secretary is proposing the revival of the Anti-Subversion Law. Does the IBP have any position on this? And he said he wants to include specifically to in our show, he said he wants the Makabayan bloc in Congress to be covered.
Well, you know, we have enough laws already that govern the establishment of associations. The lawmakers and those proposing for a return of the banning or declaring illegal these associations would run counter to the Constitution. The freedom of association is enshrined in our Constitution. If you don't do violence, malinaw ho naman yung mga batas natin. There are enough laws already that would safeguard these people or anybody from using violence. Meron pa tayong human security law. Mas matindi yan. So, all of this knee-jerk reaction do not help at all. You know, what is needed is honest-to-goodness police work, intelligence work, and a justice system that delivers justice sa lalong madaling panahon. You know, additional laws, especially those laws that tend to curb and label people or associations, does not help at all. It is a retrogression ho kung titignan natin.
If the anti-subversion law is revived, is the IBP going to challenge it in court?
It's possible, not only IBP, but many other lawyers, because it will run into constitutional difficulties. At nasubukan na ko yan eh. So I don't know, you know, Congress will only put itself in a bind or even embarrass itself kung makikinig sila dito sa mga knee-jerk reactions and suggestions. If you look at the recent security laws that were passed, there are enough processes and mechanisms by which the law enforcement and the security agencies of the state can do their job. Ang kinakailangan ko siguro, imbes na magpasa na naman ng mga draconian laws, eh, pag-igihin na lang ko ang kanilang trabaho and get the citizenry to cooperate with them and get the other pillars of the justice system to do their work as well.